got involved with Barter in East Tilbury because I work as an artist with my collaborator Karen Guthrie, and we were invited by Thurrock Council to come to East Tilbury and to make, at the time, quite a small public art project. When I came here, I fell in love with the place, basically, and I decided I wanted to do a much bigger project, and I had an idea that I wanted to go to Zlín in the Czech Republic, which is the place where the Barter Empire began, and it's also the place that physically East Tilbury is based on, so the houses here look exactly the same as some of the ones in Zlín. So originally we opened a travel agency in what was the original director's office in the then abandoned sort of factory building, and the travel agency advertised this trip and people could apply to come on it, and then we spent a year raising the money, and then we went on the bus trip in 2004 with about I think about 40 people to Zlín to sort of discover what Barter was all about, really. Well, we went with a very sort of open, I guess a sort of, I went certainly with an open mind as to what we would find, because some people see Barter as very utopian, others see it as a very oppressive place to work, and I was interested to sort of see how I came out the other side of it. And actually I have to say that I personally am full of admiration for him, and the original Barter had some very progressive ideas, I think, some of which are still very relevant today. You know, the film is called We Are Not Afraid of the Future, which is one of his sort of catchphrases, as well as, you know, work collectively, live individually, and all these kind of sort of strange sayings. We went in a way to sort of try and unpick those a little bit and meet other people who worked for him and hear the stories of the people on the bus sort of unfold on the journey.
So very much in Hertfordshire, Essex, there's the tradition since 1947 of the new town, the Garden City. Was he, although he came from East Tilbury, was he part of that progressive movement?
I think he sort of predates it, really. I think he's, you know, in a way, he's sort of ahead of his time very much. He talked about all the houses needing a garden and light and space around them. And I mean, even if you walk around East Tilbury today, I think you either love it or you hate it. But you can't really argue that some of the houses that I think are great. And people have lived in them for years and years and years and don't want to move. They love living here. So yeah, I think he was very much ahead of his time in terms of both his approach to the way he manufactured the actual shoes and the way that he worked with the workers in the factory. Not in East Tilbury, I don't think, sadly. I don't know, you know, British manufacturing's changed, but world manufacturing's really changed as well. I think it'd be very difficult now to imagine a company like Barter existing again. And, it, you know, it was a very sort of top-down, patriarchal way of working, which nowadays I think probably wouldn't happen for, you know, some good reasons, but I think at the time a lot of the people who worked for him did find it an amazing experience, and I think he as an individual is a very interesting man.
So as a filmmaker, would you ever return here to make a film, or is your work done here?
I kind of feel like my work as a filmmaker is done here, but as you can see, I'm back here at the open day, and I come back, you know, every 6 months or so. I've definitely sort of started a long-term love affair with East Tilbury, that's for sure.